Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about how you do agreement. I want to show you when you're making an agreement, what you should and what you shouldn't do. So, let's begin. Let's talk about agreement. The first thing that you need to know is everything that you do, make sure you write it down, or if you're online and you send someone an email, make sure they confirm it. The reason why I'm saying this is every agreement that you make, if you make it oral, then it's hard to prove that you make that agreement. But if you have it in writing, that's a different story. So if you get an email or if you talk with someone about certain kind of agreement, make sure you put that into writing and send it to them and ask them for confirmation. When you have that, then you have an agreement. If you don't have that, you don't have an agreement, and then it's hard to prove that you have an agreement with a certain kind of person. Second thing is keep it simple. Most people think about, okay, if I'm going to do something, a project, I need to take care of this. But it's gonna get complicated. What you need to do is keep it simple. It's that simple. When you keep something simple, then it's easy to work and people know what they need to do and what they shouldn't do. It's that simple. So when you make an agreement, keep it simple. Another point is deal with the right people. I want to give you an example. If I'm doing business with Apple, I need to make sure that the director signed the agreement. If an employee signed the agreement, then I don't have an agreement with Apple. It's that simple. So when you have an agreement, make sure you're dealing with the correct person. If you're not dealing with the correct person, you don't have an agreement with the company or with the person. And make sure that the person signed the document. Make sure that the person confirmed what you are saying. If they do not do that, then you don't have an agreement. So make sure when you're doing business with someone or you're signing an agreement, make sure you're dealing with the correct person. Another thing that often goes wrong is identify the correct party. Most of the documents, I do not see who's the party of the contract. Most of the time, I do not see who's the responsible person for the contract. What you need to do is, when you have an agreement with the person, make sure you have the name, address, Chamber of Commerce number. Just make sure you have every information in it. If you do not have that, then it's hard to identify who's the party. And if you do not have that, then you do not know which way you have an agreement or not. So my tip to you is make sure you do this correctly. Let's talk about the agreement. Make sure when you're making an agreement, just make sure you put the details in the agreement. Most of the time it goes wrong just because the details are not correct. If you're planning to deliver something on day X, make sure you deliver it on a day X, but make sure you also put it under the agreement. If you do not put it, then you're going to have a discussion. You say you will deliver, but when will you deliver? That's one of the examples of many problems that you will see when the details are not correct. So make sure when you make an agreement that the details are correct. If you need to get pay in the agreement, or you need to pay someone, make sure you put that in details in the agreement. Make sure you put that when you're going to pay and what happened when you pay. If you do not do that, you can get a problem. So what I'm advising you is make sure you put that in an agreement. Another point is if you make an agreement, make sure that both parties know if they want to get rid of the agreement, under what condition they can get rid of the agreement. Most agreement that I see daily is that people have an agreement, but they do not make appointment how to get rid of the agreement, and they want to get rid of the agreement. And sometimes it can be difficult if the other party doesn't work along with this idea. So my advice to you is make sure you put into agreement how you can get rid of the agreement, how you can terminate the agreement. If you do not do that, you will have a problem when you have that. A lot of times when you have an agreement, sometimes you can have a dispute. So sometimes you can have a discussion. Sometimes you want to explain things differently than another thing. So sometimes you have a problem. Sometimes you have a discussion. What are you going to do about it? In an agreement, you can make sure that there are rules when you guys have a disagreement. And when you put that in the agreement, it's easy for party to resolve the dispute. So what I'm trying to say is, when you make an agreement, make sure you make rules of how you can solve discussion between parties. If you do not do that, you can have a problem on the long run. So make sure you have that in the contract. Another thing is, when you make an agreement, make sure that you put in the agreement which law of which country apply for this contract. If you cannot do that, you will have a problem. So make sure you put that into writing. And last but not least, when you make an agreement, keep it confidential. If you do not do that, it can hurt the other party and it can also hurt you. So make sure that both parties keep the agreement confidential. If you have questions about this or anything related to agreement, feel free to contact me. See you in the next video.
Power.